Is there a way to combine? I think I'm gonna check the manual. I want to make sure there's no way to combine our clothes or something like that. I think you just select it, but. No, yeah, okay, so it fairly recently, wow. He isn't, yeah, Wow, so we needed the preppy outfit, we just needed all the accessories? Okay, all the other times, if you had the right outfit, but you didn't accessorize, it said, okay, you need to accessorize more, but that's not the message I got. It said you need to be trendier. How are preppy clothes trendy? All right, well, I'm glad we got it. I mean, it made little sense. Jeez. You can't trust the game. Wow. But, so basically, it was a bug. It's a bug in the game. You can't even trust its own feedback. Because, yeah, I definitely tried with the preppy outfit, and it said your clothes need to be trendier. Oh, man. Wow, you've always wanted to talk to Barbara Jo. She's the captain of the cheerleading team and the most popular girl in school. It would be an honor to be rejected by a creator of such beauty. Thank God.
Ooga! Babes ahoy! Oh, check out the gazangas on this one.
Yeah, I noticed.
Who's in charge here? All right, time to play it cool. Act real smooth. Now we need an opening line. Ask her for her autograph.
What, are you serious?
Just say it.
Can I have your autograph?
Why?
All right, tell the broad you thought she was Miss America.
You won for best all-girl sex scene at the AVNs last year, didn't you? You and Geraldine McWhiskerbox were on-screen magic.
Well, I was a semi-finalist for Majestic Little Miss Mendocino 1988.
Bingo!
I don't know, maybe you remember me from the football games?
You play football?
Are you serious? You're killing me here!
No, I'm a cheerleader.
I used to be a cheerleader in high school. And then one day, the team captain accidentally hit me with his car, and he said to me, I'm not the team captain. I'm Frank Hannon's father. Please don't let the school mascot out of his cage again. I told you this before. He's not a man in a costume, he's a wild animal. Last time you let him loose, he ate a kid.
Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, all right, move it on over. I'm taking control of this vessel.
Yeah, right. Anyway, you don't even know my name.
Okay then, sweetheart, what's your name?
And why should I tell you?
Wowie, wow, wow, this kitten's got claws. You're a real barn burner, kid. Anybody ever tell you that?
I don't think so.
Put that in writing and I'll paste it in my scrapbook. You are one ripe tomato. I don't know about you, but I'm red hot and ready to moan tonight.
Yeah, that's great. Good luck with that. I'll be with my boyfriend, Chet, tonight.
That schmo from Kokomo that works at that Ricky Tick rub joint on Bob Balaban Boulevard? Let me wake you, kid. He's Ensville. Stick with me, baby. I'm a real king bee.
Yeah, and why should I go anywhere with you?
What's the matter? You afraid you might like it?
No, I know I'm not gonna like it.
Hey, don't knock it till you tried it twice.
All right. So, I do admit this might be good for a laugh and a half, but I'm calling the shots.
You snap the whip, I'll take the trip.
Okay, I did not think we were going to pass that. But they had enough green symbols there that you're able to get it, even with the, they made that one with shit controls. Probably was both, Kitty. Probably is both. Yeah. Awful.
Score!
You would think, yeah, you would actually think they would make the, What did I want to say? Oh, now we have plenty of cash. You would think they would make, they would have a jock outfit for the cheerleader. You think the cheerleader would go for a jock outfit. So that's actually what's kind of surprising here. All right, well, we're too drunk to do the next game. So actually, I'm curious what happens if you do the moves with this while drunk.
That's it.
Oh, she liked it. Okay.
Ew, get away! Man.
What?
Gross!
Brody!
She just stands there. All right, next. Okay, ready for our date?
Let me show you why cheerleaders are simply a jump above the rest.
All right, chicks dig coordinated dudes. Show Barbara Joe how together you are as you go head-to-head with a little up and down action. Oh, trampoline time. All right, well, we've done plenty of these, but this is probably going to be harder.
Up, up, down, left, up.
Up, up, down, left, up.
Oh, no, it's easier.
Right, right, up, down, down, left, down.
Right, right, up, down, down.
Ha ha. Left, 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 up, right, button, button, left.
Left, 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 up, button, left.
Down, 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 left, right, down, right, up, up, button.
Down, down, left.
Fuck, fuck.
Up, button.
Whoops.
Oh no, it is harder, actually. Button, usually the quests button, are up, easier than the
button,
side.
Right, button,
button, button, up, button, right, button.
Up, up, right, left, up.
Up, up, right, left, up.
Button, button, up, button, down, right, left, button.
Button, button, up, button, down, button.
Down, down, right, down, up, left, button, down.
Down, down, right, down, up, left, button, down.
Oh, that was it, we did it, wow. Clutch, one, that last sequence at the end. I needed to get all of them to, I think, pass to clear into green, and we did it. Nice.
That was fun. So, what's up next?
What's next is I take a shower and meet my boyfriend out at the power station.
Ooh, that's cold.
There is music with them, but it's licensed music, so I've turned the music almost all the way down. They had, like, Right Said Fred, I'm Too Sexy for My Shirt, and whatever. But I, obviously to make this streamable, the music is very low.
Atta boy.
All right. So where are we going next? Try the phone in your room. It's time for a crank call. Just go to your room. Try the phone. What? Really? So I can't talk to her. Cat.
Sorry, Larry. Not right now.
Okay. All right, so we're going to our room. Go back to your dorm room and call her on the telephone. All right.
The library, that reminds me.
It reminds me, I need to go to the library to study for my coming exam.
yes, Larry is propelled by his farts. He just loves farting.
Listen!
And that Russell guy is everywhere. Alright, what are we doing? Phone. It's time for one of Larry's padded prank phone calls. This call's from some extra help. Okay, sperm game. From
call her up.
From Uncle Larry.
Hello? Hello?
Hello, Barbara Joe? This is your boyfriend, Chet.
This doesn't sound like Chet.
Yes, it seems I've come down with a bit of a cold. Achoo.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that, sweetie. I was gonna go out tonight. I guess I won't see you at the club then?
Yes, perhaps.
You're blowing it.
Oh, no. Don't go there. I will not be there. The club is closed tonight, so I will not be there, nor will any other people be there, because the club is closed.
Seriously? I didn't hear anything about that. What's wrong?
What's wrong?
Come on, think of something.
I'm not allowed to tell you. It is top secret.
Come on, sweetie, you can tell me.
The line's getting tight. Time to cut this one loose.
I just called to say I don't love you.
And?
And I'm engaging in sexual intercourse with your mother right now. as we are talking on the telephone. Ha, ha, ha.
Oh, just...
Oh, my. We got a real Hellcat in the sack here.
Oh, Chet, how could you? My friends warned me about you. I hate you forever. Go to hell.
Bingo.
All right, next. Barbara Wetness. Take Barbara Joe to Lefty's for a nice date. Pick her up at the sorority first. Are we going to do the wet t-shirt contest thing?
Listen, my name is...
Back to the sorority, and then we're going to go to Lefty's. So there's got to be some intersection with Uncle Larry.
Acrylics.
It'd be great if Larry Laffer... hits on her and steals the data.
Rock and roll, man.
Larry Lovish.
Oh, that guy.
You going to the Mohonk Tech?
$15, right? Yeah, we have to take her out on the hot date. Yes.
Hey, Barbara Joe, how about a drink?
No thanks, Larry. I'm not really in the mood.
Oh, come on. It'll be fun. I know a great place.
Okay.
That wasn't hard to convince her. Okay.
Ugh, where did you take me? Yuck. Everybody here is like poor and ugly and stuff.
Ladies, are you ready to get wet? I hope so, because Lefty's 2 is proud to present its third annual Hooter Soak. Contestants, please file up next to the bar.
Me, 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 me.
She wants to do it.
And to the lucky man with the dead rat floating in his beer.
Hey, that's me.
You're tonight's water boy.
Oh, I hate this. I hate this one. You finally got Barbara Joe out on a classy date. Impress the lady by getting at least 5 girls soaking wet. Don't let your water gun go empty. Right, this is good.
Woo-hoo!
Are you kidding? At least it's only 5. Any more water? Did I not get her? Nope. Oh, damn it. Oh, nice. It actually... Oh, no. It's still... yeah. I can get that. It's a lot easier than the other... The other one required us to get, like, 8 of 10 or something. I didn't get this one. No, she got in the way. Damn it. Well, I don't think we would have. I think they would have killed us anyway. I should have known better than that. This is not good because they spawned the water early, too early. Oh, nice. And I got the water too. Okay, I need water. Where's the water? No, it's 5 of 8. We already got it. Alright, good. Wait, what? Are you serious? So it counts as a loss because my water bottle or my water gun, it was empty, even though I got 5 girls, which is what the win condition was. What shit coding? Wow. And it's not good because the spawned water bottle is before we've even gone. So that's another really bad coding. Now I'm not going to get a water bottle when I need it. I don't know whether I can even win. They give it to me when I doesn't even do me any good. Oh, good. They did spawn another one, fortunately. Shit. Oh god. Well, I'm not emptying my gun. I have the 5 I needed. So I guess I just let the other 3 go off stage unless I get water. Should I soak her? Yeah. I don't have enough water to do that. So I'm just gonna let them go through and hopefully we'll win. Yeah, there was not another water bottle that spawned. So if one's at the beginning, you're screwed. Okay, yeah.
That was fun. I liked the part with the water.
Yes, water.
You don't think anybody, like, saw my boobs, do you?
Yes, boobs.
Yes. Okay. Oh, there's Larry. Barbatrot 3, I feel so sad. Hint, it's where dumb chicks live and ends in orgy. Okay. Can you just take us there?
Did I ever tell you about the time I went on a cruise on the
Yes, you did. All right, so I think that was the third. I think we only have like 2 more. We probably have like a. Well, right now we're gonna have a sperm convo, and then we might have just 1 more, maybe a trampoline after that or something. Larry's nephew. It's Larry's nephew. Okay, so things aren't going perfectly with BJ, but you've still got some tricks up your sleeve.
What's wrong?
Oh, Larry, I'm, like, so mad right now. I don't know what to do.
I'm sorry to hear that. What happened?
It's my boyfriend, Larry. Or should I say ex-boyfriend. That total a-hole. So it turns out that call I got the other day was, like, a total prank.
The other day. Ugh,
whatever. Anyway, so I confront Chet about it, and I catch him in bed with Estelle Barfus. Ugh, Barfus. Estelle Barfus. Yuck. Like... It is so over.
Barbara Jo, you sound so full of anger. And anger is only 1 letter away from danger. Now, tell me what's wrong.
Thanks, Larry, but I so do not want to talk about it right now. And no offense, Larry, but especially not with you.
Well, if you don't want to talk to me, maybe you'll feel more comfortable talking to my friend here. Timmy the Turtle.
Hey, Barbara Jo, you look sad.
Ooh, that makes Timmy sad. What's wrong, Barbara Jo?
You cannot be serious.
It's time to accept your feelings. Say to yourself, I am sad. I am frightened. I am angry. It's all right to have feelings. We all have feelings, even turtles.
Yeah, Timmy, whatever.
I don't know, Timmy. Barbara Jo still looks sad.
She sure is, Rhonda.
You know what helps me when I feel that way? A story.
Gee, Rhonda, that's a super idea.
Ooh, a story. Fun.
Hey, Rhonda, you look sad. What's wrong?
Yesterday on the playground, Max was playing magic sticks with Eunice.
That doesn't sound so bad, Rhonda.
Oh my god, I used to totally play that game. Magic sticks was like so fun.
But Max is my friend.
Well, I can be your friend too, Rhonda. Then we can play magic sticks.
Really? You'd be my friend?
Of course, Barbara Jo, Rhonda.
Neat. Oh, that sounds like fun. But later, Timmy, where are we going to find sticks?
I got the only magic stick you need right here, baby.
Oh, Timmy.
Hey, that's not how you play magic sticks. But you got me so excited. I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it. Oh, hurry, Larry, hurry.
Bingo.
Let's play some quarters.
Quarters?
Actually, I don't know why you said that. But quarters is easy. Good news is we got the money for this in advance. All right. Yes, just quarters.
Do I have to drink now?
Yes, you do.
Oh, yes, no. Yes, 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 yes!
Yeah, Yeah, it's not a prequel almost.
You hit it!
Yes!
Lucky.
I guess if you aim for the money, then you probably just pick up a dollar. But at the expense of getting a little drunk and possibly losing.
It didn't go in!
Here's my stroke.
Now, honestly, it's like hard to miss in this minigame. I mean, I've done it probably four
there
or five times.
There you go, now you're
total.
Catching on.
Yay!
Oh, I'm feeling it.
Oh man, she's like a...
Aww.
Yeah.
Oh, can I get a redo?
No, you cannot. I may have experienced this.
All right, that was fun. Maybe I'll see you on the show.
Just walks away. Yeah, they definitely gave out all the sexual... You know what I bet you happened? I have a theory about this. So for those who haven't been watching the whole game, there are 16 of these girls we have to go through. This was just number 15, so we got the token of affection for it. The first maybe six or seven, we all had like sexual encounters of various sorts with them. And then all of a sudden, we started like, yeah, there are things, either like weird things happened or they just walk away or like just like what happened now. And there's just, it's like completely anticlimactic. So I bet you what happened is, possibly they ran out of ideas, but I think more to the point, some of them were always planned to have the sexual encounters and some of them not. But I bet you, because the game was so tedious, I think they front-loaded all of the girls. They probably just changed the order since it's not very... You know, you can pretty much do them in any order. So I think they probably front-loaded all the sexual encounters early to try to get people to keep on playing it. Because I wouldn't be surprised if they had them sort of evenly dispersed throughout. People just got, like, bored. Because the gameplay sucks. And if there's not, like, the sexual payoff with the girls, it's like, what the hell am I playing this for? So I think they front-loaded all the sexual encounters for the first five or six girls, and then the rest are all kind of like... All right, let's save. What are we at? 67. Okay, we got 2/3. The climax was the wet t-shirt context. Yeah, but the other ones you actually like, you consummate the courtship, if you will, in some way. Larry gets to consummate it with them. And that was just like on a date. That wasn't the taking them. Because in all the other cases, he either took them back to his room or he went to their room.
You rimjob ass fucker!
Alright, so. Swingles finals. Time for the big show. Go talk to Yuma. Applications taken at the main campus. Alright. Hopefully, this is now our last sequence. What green arrow?
The library, that reminds me.
Oh, that's your confidence.
Hey, cockpiece! You got those tokens of affection? Great. Now get in line over there. We're about to make the announcement. Hey, how's everybody doing out there? Who out there loves TV? And who out there loves reality dating shows? Now, who out there loves swingles? Fair enough. And now, for the moment you've all been waiting for, After much deliberation, Swingles has narrowed it down to one very lucky student. And here with me to make that announcement, I have a very special guest, Walnut Log Community College's own Dean Abrahamson.
Actually, it's Assistant Dean Abrahamson, but that's due to change very shortly. I assure you.
Hey, Abrahamson! Fuck you!
Well, spring break is just around the corner, and our students get to feeling their oats just around this time.
Hey, Furnace! I fucked your wife last night!
You know, what do you say? We skip all the fanfare and get right to the envelope. Assistant Dean Abrahamson.
Larry Lovage! There must be some mistake. I will not have Larry Lovage representing this school. You hear me, Lovage? I know you're watching.
A heart attack? Where is the
good
envelope?
Good job, Larry. Now, we've already got our crew down at Fat Sam's Titty City, so head down there ASAP.
Oh, man. Can I get a ride with you guys?
No.
No, you cannot.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to yet another episode of Swingles. And we're here at Fat Sam's Titty City, taping our Swingles Swingin' Back to School special in the anal bead capital of the world, Walnut Log. Meet Larry. Larry's 25 and a seventh-year junior from parts unknown. He's an aspiring concrete form dismantler who says the first thing he notices in a girl are her boobies. And introducing our girls, Swingle number one is Barbara Jo. She's a 21-year-old junior from Airhead, California, majoring in home economics. She likes puppy dogs, sundaes, and ice cream. She doesn't like mean people. Swingle number two is Susie. She's a 22-year-old automotives major from Roadkill, New Jersey. Her turn-ons are mags, stack amps, and pain. Her turn-offs are pussies, nerds, and squares. And finally, Swingle number three is Morgan. She's a 21-year-old senior from Booberry, Delaware, majoring in popular cultural studies. Her hobbies include collecting boxes of discontinued cereal and memorabilia related to the Zapped film series. Now we're gonna join the friendly foursome as they get their evening started with a little drink and polite conversation.
On the show, Tucking It Up on Swingles. It's the big night, the night you're on the air with three luscious ladies. Doesn't luscious have a S in it? Show them what you've got, Tiger. Okay.
Sorry to keep you waiting, ladies. So, have you guys had a chance to get acquainted yet, huh?
I'm bored.
I'm scared.
I really do not want to be here.
Well, if you like, we can try for the VIP room, but I don't think there's room for the three of us and the camera crew, do you? Hey, I know what we need. How about a few cocktails to take the edge off?
Larry, don't get me wrong. I'm happy to be here, but don't you think this is a tad weird taking us to a strip bar on a date?
Why? You uptight?
I'm not uptight.
I'm uptight.
That's not what I heard.
Save some energy for later, babes. One of you is gonna need it.
Ah, perfect. Hey, how you doing? Listen, I have two-for-one coupons for these. Now, one of them is expired, but Linus said...
Larry, that's sweet of you, but I'll pay for them.
Okay! But that's not gonna earn you any special points. I gotta remain impartial until after the questions start.
Well, darn for me.
Why don't we start with our first question? On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate yourself at Whoopi?
9.
10.
Larry, what are you talking about?
Can I change my answer?
Sure, why not? Go for it.
23!
Excellent.
Yay.
Okay then, next question. Where is the strangest place you've ever juggled the old canoe?
Larry, are you talking about sex?
Yes.
Inside one of the guard towers at the Photon Laser Tag Arena.
Behind a dumpster at the last Iggy Pop concert.
Assistant Dean Abrahamson's private bathroom. But you guys have to keep that a secret.
Great! Wow! Oh, this is going way better than I thought. All right, next question. If you were magically transported to a mystical fantasy universe and had to make whoopee with a dragon in order to save the human race, would you do it? And if so, would you be angry if you found out later that the dragon was lying to you? Susie, let's start with you this time.
Yes and no.
Interesting. Barbara Jo.
What's a dragon?
I'm sorry, that question's just weird. Can we skip to the next one?
Man, you are uptight.
Because I wouldn't have sex with a dragon.
You'd sit there and rot in some cave forever just so you wouldn't have to give a dragon a blowjob?
I like dragons.
Okay, sure, fine. Under those circumstances, I would do it.
Man, what a sicko.
What? You fucking hypocrite.
I don't know about you, sweetie, but I ain't chugging dragon cock for no man, no how.
You bitch!
Ladies, a toast. Look, I just want you guys to know that if it were up to me, and I mean this sincerely, I would keep all three of you. But rules are rules, so unfortunately, I'm going to have to cut one of you loose before we advance to the next round of the date. But before that happens, I want to toast you guys and let you know that this has been, without a doubt, the best date of my entire life. Cheers!
And that's a wrap. Okay, everybody, let's move on. Places, and 5, 4, 3.
All right.
All right, swingers, and now it's time to enter our second round of swingles, and you know what that means. Somebody's gotta go. Who will it be? Susie, Morgan, or Barbara Jo?
I don't wanna go home.
Okay, hang on. Oh. So we have to choose who we're eliminating? Or are we talking?
I'd like to Deepak her, Chopra.
Knock him dead, kid.
Are you sure? Yeah, eliminate. Susie sucks. Eliminate her.
Oh, well, it looks like Susie is the lucky loser.
Run before he reconsiders, honey.
What a dumb fuck. I don't waste my time with nerds.
Now we'll continue our evening at the power station where we're having an underwear dance party. Well, you guys are certainly stooping to new lows with every episode, aren't you?
Shut up, bitch!
Sexy swingle dancing. You're almost there. Only one more challenge to go. Then you're off to do a private dance called the Horizontal Mambo with a gorgeous babe of your choice. All right, why don't we, I know there were the buys opened up, so let's quickly just get to those, and then hopefully we'll finish it off. Okay, so let's resume. There are two Murder, She Wrote games, in fact. All right, only one more challenge. Nice. Oh, it's the dancing one. It's good
up,
rhythm.
Left, left, right, left.
Up, left, left, right, left.
Down, right, down, right.
Down, down, right, down, right.
Damn, you're good.
Down, button, left, right, right, up, left, down.
Down, button, left, right, right, up, left.
Down, right, button, 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 up, right.
Down, right, button, 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 up, right.
Yeah.
Why are all the everyone's
right,
clothes off for this?
Left, down.
Right, left, down,
down, button, down,
down, button, down,
button, button, left,
button, button, left,
button, button, down,
button, button, down.
I'm feeling naughty.
Right, right,
down,
down,
up,
down, button.
Right, right, down, down, up, down, button.
Right, left, right, button, right, button, button.
Right, left, right, button, right, button, button.
Do it!
You do it.
Left, right, right, left.
Left, right, right, left.
Button.
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 Right, left, left, right.
Right, left, left, right.
Button.
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 Up, down, down, down.
Up, down, down,
down. Down, up, up, up.
Down, up, up, up.
There you go. Ooh.
Oh, well, try. Hey, wait a second, I won!
What do you know?
And now, Larry will have to make his final decision. Who's it gonna be?
Are we picking who we want or who we're eliminating?
Come on, Larry. Keep me in the game, coach.
I guess we're picking who we want. All right, I'm gonna have to go with, as much as I had fun with Where Were Joe, we gotta go with Morgan. I thought she was the coolest. Despite her apparently being a nerd. Oh, no. Okay, we are picking who to eliminate. All right, sorry, Barbara Joe.
Sorry, Barbara Joe. That's the way love goes.
My feet hurt. I think my feet hurt from dancing. I like dancing.
Well, that's all from Swingles. We're packing up the van and leaving this crap hole, and who knows, viewers, maybe we'll be swinging on through whatever town you live in.
You think our town's a crap hole? You're a crap hole!
Guys, let's get out of here.
Thought I'd fall for a guy like you, but I can't help myself. I think I love you, Larry Lovage.
I love you too, Morgan Freeman. Miss Yasmin, I don't know how to thank you. Yesterday was the greatest day of my life, and you know, I think I've turned over a new leaf. I might even go to all my classes tomorrow.
There's no class tomorrow, Larry. It's spring break.
Spring break?
Uncle Larry, what are you doing here?
Come on, dudester, let's party!
Yes, Larry, a party!
Hey, nephew, check this one out! Nice, huh?
Yeah, sure thing, Uncle Larry. But where's Assistant Dean Abramson? How's he letting this happen?
Don't worry, Larry, I took care of that.
Lovage, I know you're behind this! I'm gonna get you for this, Lovage! And when I do, spring break is canceled! You hear me, Lovage? Canceled!
Hey, everybody!
What do you say? Let's party!
It's over. Our long national nightmare. I don't know. This could be licensed music too. Who knows? Oh my god. I guess that the end counted as a token of affection, or did we miss one? I don't know whether we did. Oh yeah, I'm sure that's not. Alright. Play some more classic Larry music. Oh. Yeah, I'm sure there are alternate. Slight, well, not alternate endings, but probably Because that ending was clear. They had all three girls up there, regardless of who you chose. It probably played out the same way. Inko, thank you for the $35.38. Thank you so much, Inko. Appreciate it.
Freedom.
Thank you for the support. Thank you. I'm sure it's just they swap in the one scene, the scene that occurred in the bedroom, but of course nothing untoward occurred there, so don't worry about it. Yeah, so I don't know, just pretty much an awful game. I mean, there were some funny lines here or there, for sure. I definitely chuckled a few times, but man, in general, I mean, the gameplay is just so bad. It's the same mini games repeated ad nauseum. And the same mini games that appear in the main quests also appear on the side to boost your confidence, to get money. So you have to grind mini games just to play the same mini games in the quests with the main girls. So it's just so bad. I think the humor just was worse than all the prior Larry games, mostly because there's no like clever dialogue or double entendres or anything. They just go like all out with really crude stuff, which, I mean, look, I guess there's a place for it and some people are into it, but like sometimes it's just like downright uncomfortable. I don't think it's the sort of game that probably ages too well, even in the, 17 years since this was released in 2004, but, oh man, what a, I mean, it's also not an adventure game too. I think that much is clear. All of the gameplay just, there's no puzzle solving. All the gameplay just resolves around the same action mini games. So. We get a post-credits scene. What? Is this like wander mode or what? What's happening now? The van didn't crash?
Artie, that's it. I can't work like this.
Picking up girl 601. Oh my gosh. In this special director's cut, see how Larry and Uma first met O and hit icons and stuff? Oh no. So, oh, there is Uma, so we can get the 16th one. Well, why not? We've come this far, right?
Hey, baby. Don't I know you from somewhere?
No. I'm quite sure we've never met.
No, we have met before. I'm sure of it. Maybe the relaxation spa over near the airport?
Okay. I'm on TV, all right. It's no big deal. I host a reality dating show. Didn't you see the cheap-ass set on your campus's lawn? It's a major plot point of the game, for Christ's sake.
No, that's not it.
Fuck.
I know, Playboy, the girls of Keratop issue. Yeah, I've seen you naked.
No, not at all. Done a little modeling, some theater, nothing you'd remember, I'm sure.
No, I definitely remember you. Terms of Enrearment! The French Maid, right? Third scene, you and Reginald Ramjet.
Look, there are a lot of people in the world and some of them look like each other, okay?
Oh, no. I recognize you. I'd know those dimples anywhere. Besides, I've seen that movie 100 times, and it's definitely you.
Look, you little pervert. I've been clawing my way out of cable hell for the past 5 years, and I'm not gonna have you fuck it all up by telling the whole world about some goddamn skin flick I made when I was 18 fucking years old!
Okay, jeez, I'm sorry. I was just gonna say that I really admired your work. Most actresses just kinda sit there pretending to enjoy themselves. I remember you because you really got into it.
I'm so very flattered. Now get the hell out of here before I have my assistant bring me my taser gun.
See you in the ending cinema, I guess.
Did you, really think I was that good?
Are you kidding? I don't mean to sound like one of those obsessed fans, okay, but I have three copies of that tape. One at home, one at school, and one in a safe deposit box in case my school and my parents' house burns down. Best performance I've ever seen, bar none. And believe me, I know good rear entry when I see it.
Just between you and me, that was the most difficult acting experience I've ever had in my entire life. Everyone looks down on those hoes for what they do. They earn their money. I'd like to see Susan Sarandon try a scene like that.
Me too.
Okay, Larry, nice talking to you. Good luck with the rest of the game, and do me a favor and keep that tape to yourself, huh?
Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba.
Great. The one guy in the world who has a copy of the porno I did, and I have to run into him.
So wait, is this, so we can do Uma? Unclear? Uma chat. There are no quite objectives. So I guess that was it. End with love. Through the power of the porn fairy, see what would have happened if you had chosen Morgan. We did choose Morgan. This activates Morgan's End Cinema, which can be viewed from the Black Book replay. Maybe you have to unlock these, I guess? Oh, we ended up with 71%, by the way. All right, so let's give out 4 for that. Also, 15 Cedrics for the game taking 15 hours and 44 minutes. I just want to make sure there's no... They said 601, so I thought there might be a 602 or something, but there are no more objectives, so... I guess the rest of the game is just one. They just have a wander mode where you can continue.
South side!
Nice.
But she's doing it too?
I have enough money and enough fame to get away with killing a person. Don't make me do it. Great. The one guy in the world who has a copy of the porno I did, and I have to run into him. I have enough money and enough fame to get away with killing a person. Don't make me do it.
All right. Well, I guess yeah. No, I guess that's it. Cause there are no more objectives. So I think that's it. And we did all the side quests. Okay, so that's it. So they just had that one conversation. But we didn't get the hang on. Did we get the token of affection? I don't think we did. No, we didn't. So is there a 16th? Either Uma or Sweet Lou. We missed one token of affection. I guess. I don't know. Strange. All right. Well, I'm glad it's over. Very glad it's over. So yeah, I mean, obviously your mileage may vary into whether you found any of the content objectionable. Some of it was pretty tough to listen to and stomach, I'm not gonna lie. Others of it was funny. I mean, it's over the top, but whatever. But yeah, they could never make this game now. It'd be very difficult to make this game now. But yeah, the gameplay sucks. There's no getting around it. If you're going to make your gameplay entirely minigame based, make sure the minigames are good and not bugged. It was so weird how they would like, it would be variable controls, whether you'd have precise controls or controls going all over the place. Oh my God. It's really bad. I just can't imagine how Box Office Bust is worse than this. I guess because maybe if it's a platformer, maybe the game's so broken, you can't really play it, perhaps. But yeah, having to do the same, you had the sperm conversation game, the rhythm one with the arrows, the rhythm one with the button presses, tapper, distribute items, quarters, and trampoline. Or no, trampoline was the other rhythm one. So it was just the same ones recycled. Oh, and there were two wet t-shirt ones. And then the photo ones. Oh, they're so bad. They're so bad. So yeah, I mean, it's a shame. It's really a shame. They took, you know, a well-regarded and loved series like this and put it down the absolute crapper and apparently continue it with Box Office Bust. So this is easily one of the worst games we've had on the Adventure Quest. Easily. It's definitely bottom 10, but stay tuned for where I ultimately rank it in that bottom 10. So let's head to our Hollow of Adventure. Yeah, and I could see why Hollow. Yeah, absolutely. Total legacies. They probably just pissed all over, just like Larry Lovage pissed over every girl he came across. That would happen there. All right, and go to bookshelf number 2, or bookcase number 2. Game 296, Leisure Suit Larry, Magna Cum Laude. Put it up on the shelf.